it's always so interesting to kind of be the more beautiful you guy. You know, I go somewhere and sometimes that's the only song people know, but the thing that I realize is that, you know, every song I write, whether it's More Beautiful You or just another track on the album, I write very intentionally. I put so much thought and so much just effort into trying to make it the best I can make it so that God can use it. And so it's so important to me to get not only More Beautiful You out there, but so many other songs as well. I have so much that I want to say to the church and to the people listening to the music. So help me see through the eyes of the hurting. This record for me was so much fun to make. Every record that I've ever made until now was actually an indie record. Even More Beautiful You, a lot of people don't know, was an indie record that ended up getting signed. I went back to Steve Wilson, who recorded More Beautiful You, did some songs with him. And then I did some songs with Chris Stevens, who does stuff for Sanctus Real, Toby Mac, just some other great artists. And then one of my all-time favorite producers is a guy named Ed Cash, and I was able to do the bulk of the record with him. And I've always wanted to work with him because I've loved his stuff, and I've always heard great things about working with him. You know, I actually grew up listening to country music, and one of the great things about country music is a lot of the songs tell these amazing stories, you know, that'll make you laugh, make you cry. And so I grew up listening to that, and that's kind of one of the things I include in my songwriting. It's just I take a character and I kind of move him through the song, and hopefully through that character can encourage the listeners. Well, that's kind of how my shows are. It's more of just, let's make this church feel like a living room. Let's make it feel like we're all just kind of sitting together and I'm telling you, hey, this is what this song is about, this is what this song's about, and playing through the songs. And I try and make it almost feel like a little sneak peek into like what just jamming in my living room would be like. We couldn't fit 1,000 people in here. It's a lie. This year has been a really good year for me to learn what it is that I'm capable of as far as being on the road, how much is healthy for me, for my marriage, for my family. You know, my wife and I don't have kids yet. We've only been married about 2.5 years. And so that's one thing that makes it a little easier, not having to leave kids, but even just being away from my wife, because I love sharing songs, I love playing concerts, I love getting to know fans. And this year has taught me, you know, if I really want this ministry to be as effective as it can be and to do everything that God's called me to do, I have to be wise with my time and I have to always keep my marriage first and just my health and everything, keep that the priority. So my mission statement, to entertain, to encourage, and to challenge the body of Christ. And so every song I write hopefully falls into one of those three categories. And so for a little while, I was kind of dry, just trying to think of ideas that would entertain, encourage, and challenge that I haven't said before. But then one of the beautiful things about being in Nashville is that there are some amazingly talented writers here. And I was able to do co-writes, and they kind of encouraged me to look at things maybe in a different way. Maybe it was something that I had already approached in the song, but I came at it in a different direction, came at it a different way. So that's kind of the beauty of co-writing. It just kind of opens you up, opens up this whole new palette of things to write about, things to share. And so that's really the new songs on this record. They all fall into that category, whether it's simply entertaining, encouraging, or challenging the body of Christ. The beauty of the cross.